As the war of words heats up between the U.S. and North Korea, the reclusive regime is threatening to attack Guam, where the U.S. has an Air Force base. Hawaii, also within North Korea's striking distance. So how is that state preparing? CNN's Sarah Seidner explains from Honolulu.
We're inside a bunker inside the Diamond Head crater. There are 6 feet of concrete above me, 6 feet of concrete in the walls. This is the place where the Emergency Operating Center State Warning Point exists. And the reason why this place is so important is this is where the warning to all the Hawaiian Islands will come from. See that phone there? That phone will get a phone call from Pacific Command once they determine that a missile is coming from North Korea headed this way. Then this phone will be picked up, HWAS. This will send out a call to all of the counties simultaneously, and they will warn their population that this is going to be an attack and to prepare. There will also be a tone that will be sent from here, that is the plan, to all of the islands, and you will hear a warning sound and a siren coming to all the islands. There will be also simultaneously everything going out on the television so that you'll know that this is happening here on the Hawaiian Islands. Now, one of the most important things that people need to know is you can survive this if you are a certain amount away from where the detonation happens. And in order to do so, though, you need to have a plan. Here's the kicker. There is only 20 minutes from the time of launch from North Korea before the bomb falls here in Hawaii. It doesn't give you much time. You'll probably have 15 minutes warning to get somewhere safe. And that is something that this state is the first to work on, that plan to try and save lives in case of a nuclear attack. Sarah Seidner, CNN, Honolulu.
Okay, well, that puts a fine point on it.
Key to surviving a nuclear blast is getting out and not going into harm's way. That's basically all we're going to be talking about here. And the farther you are away in distance, the longer it is in time from the initial blast, and the more separation between you and the outside atmosphere, the better. So separation, hopefully with dirt or concrete, or being in a basement, distance and time is what will save you. So here's what you do. First of all, as I said, don't stare at the light flash. If you can, I don't know how you could possibly resist doing that, but let's assume theoretically you want to do that. You want to keep your mouth open so your eardrums don't burst from the pressures. If you're very close to what happened, you actually do have to duck and cover, like Bert told you, Bert the turtle. And you want to get under something so that you're not injured or killed by objects, if that's at all possible. You want to get away from the initial fallout mushroom cloud, I said in just a few minutes, and shelter in place. You want to move crosswind for 1.2 miles. You know, if you're out there and you see buildings horribly destroyed and down in that direction, less destroyed here, then you know that it was over there, the blast, and you're going this way, as long as you're going crosswise to the wind. Once you're out and evacuating, you want to keep as much of your skin, your mouth, and nose covered, as long as that covering doesn't impede you moving and getting out of there. And finally, you want to get decontaminated as soon as possible. And if you're wearing clothing, you're taking off your clothing, you're going to get showered down someplace and remove the radiation that would be the radioactive material that might be on you. And then you want to stay in shelter for 48 to 72 hours minimum, but you're going to wait, hopefully. You'll have your little wind-up battery-less radio, and you'll be waiting for people to tell you when it's safe to go outside. That's what you need to do.